Michael as a buck to beat the Wizards 133-122, Mark.
Absolutely, Maria. A guy we take for granted. Continues to put up MVP-type numbers. Stellar basketball player. Sets the tone for that Buck team and gives them a chance year in and year out. I'm sure Buck fans are excited to have him tied up for a long time to come.
Consecutive MVP awards. First to do it since Steph Curry did it in 25 and 2016. Curry has already passed Reggie Miller. He's closing in on Ray Allen for the all-time lead in made threes. And you were mentioning before the break that the Celtics were interested in Reggie Miller, and you just got confirmation that that was true.
Absolutely. Future Hall of Fame coach Doc Rivers put a stamp on exactly what I was talking about. He said not only that, they had tried several times to tie up Reggie Miller and bring him back out of retirement. Think about that team, and Reggie would have a championship ring. And to me, that's why I don't say a guy is a champion because he wins. Reggie Miller's a championship basketball player. I watched him. I watched him every single day. Everything about him said champion. The same way I looked at Steph Curry. When I had him, he was a champion.
Curry has now won three titles. Mentioned the two MVPs, seven All-Star appearances, including just last week, where he was a teammate of LeBron James for the first time in their careers in all the All-Star games they participated in. Curry played the entire first quarter, 15 points, 6 and 10, 2 of 4 from 3. Horton Tucker, meanwhile, having an excellent night off the bench. In fact, he's the Lakers' leading scorer right now. He's got 8 points, and L.A. has an 8-point advantage.
That's exactly who he is and what he brings to the table. They played him last year in the bubble, gave him opportunity, and nobody knew, you know, what he was able to do, but he can score from day one in this game.
Montrezl Harrell goes up for the dunk. He's the leading scorer now with 11 for the Lakers. They have a 10-point lead on the road against the Warriors.
Another feed by Kuzma, making the play, and we see the Lakers going to his zone, but Kuzma putting pressure on the defense.
Oubre able to get it to go, and one, so Kelly Oubre will go to the foul line to try to complete the three-point play.
Stops at the three-point line, gets the defense on his heel, forces help, and then hands it off to Harrell, who does the rest. This is outstanding offense. Great presence and awareness by Kuzma.
Harrell picks up the foul on the other end, his second. Oubre misses the free throw. 73% free throw shooter. His offense has skyrocketed the last month and a half after a slow start, averaging close to 20 points per game since the start of February. James into the lane. Good pass to Harrell. And then Harrell takes a shot to the face. And a technical foul is called on Wiseman because it was a dead ball situation. Let's see if they count the basket.
I'm not sure if
they counted the bucket by Montrezl Harrell, and then they called a technical on Wiseman for the elbow upstairs.
Pascoe's in the action also, so yeah, it is Wiseman, you're right. They're going to take a look at that.
At first, Mark, it looks like it's inadvertent right here, but then watch there.
No, that's not inadvertent.
No, I'm talking about the first time on the way down. Looked like he got
on the way down.
Watch here.
Yeah,
there, that's
fine.
Inadvertent. That's not. The second one was not.
The problem is looking at the replay.
So after the goaltending violation, there's a hostile act committed by Wiseman. The play is under review to see if it meets the criteria for penalty.
Dave, the problem is on the replay, the second action doesn't look like it connects to Harrell at all. He sells that second contact. The first one is the one that hit him.
Let's see, is he selling these or just in pain from the first hit? I think he was in pain just from the first hit as opposed to an act.
Absolutely. That's why I feel like it, though. So that's why I say it's not a hostile act, because the second one does not connect.
Yeah, guys, maybe show that other angle again under the basket, because that was one, Mark, you pointed out where it looked like there was no contact with that. The second elbow.
Yeah, the first one absolutely connects.
And again, there, that angle, it looks like it does, but we had another angle that we showed you. earlier where it looked like there wasn't contact. Okay, here it is. Now watch, there's the contact, and then, right, you don't see it. But I think, again, he's going back and is in pain because of the first elbow, which was inadvertent.